Assalamu alaikum Adab. Welcome to the presentation on geological time scale. Geological time scale is the chronological sequence of Earth's history. The development of Earth has taken place over a period of billions of years. The evolution of life is also a part of the Earth's geological history. From Big Bang till today, the time frame of Earth's evolution has been very, very extensive. The calendar of geological events that can be termed as geological time scale. Arthur Holmes, a British geologist who was the first to propose a geological time scale in 1913. Evidences that are collected, like from fossil records, like from stratigraphic correlations, radioactive dating, paleomagnetic dating, orbital revolution and rotation of the Earth. And these are time and again used for the updating of this geological time scale. Way back before the origin of the Earth, 4.5 billion years before, there have been the great events like Big Bang, formation of galaxies, origin of star systems, including our solar system. In geological time scale, the units that are used are given in the slide here. Generally, millennium, century, decade, etc. are used to denote periods. But in geological time scale, we use eon, era, period, epoch, and age. Eon, it denotes half a billion years or more time. Whereas era is used to refer to the duration of several hundred millions of years. Period represents about 100 million years, and epoch is for tens of millions of years. Age covers duration of millions of years in the Earth history. The slide here shows the geological time scale with its divisions in eon, periods, epochs, and their durations. Here, no correlation between these different divisions and the events in geological history hasn't been done. It is only the classification or divisions of the geological units, geological time scale units, and their durations have been shown here. The geological time scale is basically divided into two eons. It is Cryptozoic eon and Phanerozoic eon. Cryptozoic eon, as is before us, Cryptozoic eon, crypto means hidden, zoo means life. Cryptozoic eon is the eon in which life originated, and then life continued for most of the time as in its acellular form, that is in its microscopic form. So it is called the eon of hidden life. Cryptozoic eon is the time of mainly acellular life or hidden life. It is classified into two eras as far as the origin and evolution of life is concerned, Archean era and Proterozoic era. This is Archean era. There have been many significant observations in this Archean era. Archean era, that is about 3000 million years before, witnessed the origin of life and evolution of prokaryotes, that is bacteria and blue-green algae. This is Proterozoic era, about 2000 million years before, saw the origin and evolution of eukaryotic cells and then higher forms of invertebrates like sponges, cnidarians, worms, and annelids. Phanerozoic eon. Phanerozoic eon, that is from 540 million years before to the present day. This eon is called the eon of, it is called the eon of visible life, because Phaneros means visible and the zoo means life. eon of visible life on Earth. It witnessed and recorded the origin and evolution of higher invertebrates and also vertebrates, that is fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. Three eras are there in Phanerozoikian, that is Paleozoic era, Mesozoic era and Cenozoic era. The Paleozoic era that we see, it lasted from 540 million years to around 245 million years. It's called the cradle of ancient life. Mesozoic era, it is lasted from about 245 million years to about 65 million years. It's called the golden age of reptiles. Reptiles used to rule the earth during this era. Cenozoic era, from 65 million years to present, it is called the age of mammals. Mammals flourished in this very age, including human beings. This is a slide. On the right side, we see there is the geological time scale. Not only the divisions of the geological time scale, but some of the events as far as the life, origin and evolution of life is concerned, and mostly in terms of zoology, it has been shown. In summary, we see this Precambrian or Cryptozoic, it comprises 87% of the geological time. Life appeared and evolved mostly at lower level, microscopic level in Cryptozoic, although multicellular forms, that is lower invertebrates, also did appear. Life bloomed at higher levels in Phanerozoikian. Higher levels, we mean higher invertebrates as well as vertebrates. Paleozoic era comprises age of invertebrates and as well as vertebrates. Vertebrates like fishes and amphibians. In Mesozoic era, reptiles ruled the earth, so it's called the golden age of reptiles. Cenozoic era is known as the age of mammals. Evolution of modern humans happened in Pleistocene epoch. We see different epochs here, that is Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene, Pleistocene, Holocene. It has been this Pleistocene where the human evolution of modern human has happened, and rise of human civilizations on this surface of Earth. It has been a very recent event. It has been just from about 10,000 years before. Also, one important point to note here that there can be a minor variation in dates between different geological time scales, but these are ignorable when the dates are said to be approximate dates. The slide shows International Chronostratigraphic Chart 2020, International Commission on Stratigraphy. It has been designed, and the minute details or divisions of the geological time scale has been shown here in this chart. These are the references. Thank you.